But it's all right. Riding around in the prison, it's all right. If you live a life you please, well, it's all right. Doing the best you can, well, it's all right. As long as you're in the hand, you can sit around and wait for your morning. Waiting for someone to tell you everything. Sit around and wonder what tomorrow is. Maybe that
it's alright. Even if the sea are wrong, well, it's alright. Sometimes you gotta be strong. Well, it's alright. As long as you got someone to love.
This is Ray, and this is a cancer video. And the reason it's a cancer video is I got another, a lady wrote me a letter, and she called me every name that she could think of, all because she saw a YouTube video where I was talking about cancer, and I was smoking. I was doing this. And she just come right out and said, man, you should be dead and my mom should be alive. And she might be right about that. And you don't know what to say in cases like that. And that's not the first one I've got, man. Let me tell you, I got a lot of them. But this one, I replied back, man, I'm sorry about your mom, but I got to live my life the way I feel, and that's all I can say. And she wrote back, and she cussed me out, and the thing I kept thinking about, man, here's this cancer that destroyed her life, took her mom. And I'll be damned, this cancer is still destroying. It's eating her up. She's consumed with it. And her mom is long since gone. But the cancer is still destroying her. That's what I hate about pancreatic cancer. That's what I hate about all cancers. It can be long gone and people like her resent people like me who just, you know, they told me I had 2 years to live. You think I'm gonna quit smoking? I mean, you gotta be crazy. I mean, it's the only enjoyment I've got. I give up everything, and this cancer took everything. I went from 186 pounds to 114. I went from working two jobs, 71 hours a week to Social Security disability and couldn't even work out in the yard. Nah, man. It should be none of your business how I live my life, man, or how I die, because everybody's got their own way, and you could look at pancreatic cancer, and there is no right way. Positive attitude, you think that's going to pull you through? That's an insult to the people that I know that have died, that had the strongest, most positive attitude that you could have, and they still died. And these are people that I know, not just from online. I drove to visit them. And I called him on the phone. One friend I had lived in Canada. I talked to him on the phone all the time. Had the strongest attitude. Had a wife and a daughter, and he went. And, you know, everybody got their own way of dealing with this. Some people totally change everything. Their diet, everything. Exercise, and it don't matter, man. They still die. Here I am, 12 years. September 27th was 12 years. And you think I'm safe? I just had a friend, Carla, who was right behind me. She had 11 years. She thought she had it beat too. And it came back. In her 11th year, I'd be damned if it didn't come back. So, you know, me, I think I got it beat. I don't give a damn. If it comes back on me, I don't give a damn. To be truthful with you, I'm tired of fighting it. I mean, I don't have any kind of quality of life anyhow. If I did, it'd be different. You know, some people have a decent quality of life, and man, I'm all for you. You want to juice up and stuff like that, I'm all for you, man. You ain't never going to hear me tell you how to live your life. That's not my right. I don't have no right to tell you how to live or how to die. Now, unless this woman that wrote me is going to die for me, she got no right to tell me how to live, what time I got left. And it just upset me a little bit. This time, I don't know, there was something about it. She called me so many names, and I mean, she just come right out and said, you should be dead, and my mom should be alive. You know, that could be true, but it's not true. I am alive, and as long as I am, I will smoke, and I will eat what I want, and I'll lay down at 1 o'clock in the afternoon and take a nap if I want, you know. Whatever I feel like doing, I'm going to do. And so, anyway, right now, I'm dealing with so much stuff, man. This is stupid, man, because I got a cracked rib. I got no body, no muscle mass at all, skin and bone. Pushing a grocery cart, slipped my hand off of it, fell forward, and the corner of that cart went up into my ribs, and I can't hardly breathe, man. And I'm dealing with that, and I'm telling you, this sucker hurts. You know, I can't even take a deep breath, you know. And so, I don't know. You're out there fighting this cancer, just do the best you can, and don't let anybody try to change your way of doing it. Steve Jobs died, but I said he went out the way that he chose. He chose a path that had he chose another way, he might live. But, man, I'm saying, you know, cheers to you, Steve, for doing it your way. That's how I want to go out. I want to go out my way, living, taking responsibility for my own choices. And that's the way you should be. You shouldn't live your life for anybody else, man, because ain't nobody going to step up and say, hey, when it comes your turn, I'll die for you. You know, so just shut up. Don't send me no more emails, okay? It hurts, man. It's got a sting to it because I don't know why I'm here. I don't know why being a bad patient as I am that I'm alive, but I am. And I'm not going to apologize for it because it had not been easy. It's not easy now. And sometimes I think the lucky ones are the ones that are gone. You may not agree with that, but there are plenty of times when I just said, I'm tired. I'm really tired. And I don't need you to make it worse, you know. So anyway, I'll just live my life the way I want, and we'll see how it all works out.
Maybe somewhere down the road, at the end of the line, you'll think of me and wonder where I am these days. At the end of the line, maybe somewhere down the road when somebody plays. At the end of the line, purple day. Well, that's all right. And the bush comes to show. Well, it's